this is an evolving landscape. I think it goes hand in hand with developments in cell and gene therapy. So things offered products we used to see some time ago are no longer in vogue, and we see new technologies appearing, new offerings appearing. So I would say the current landscape involves a lot of offering of perinatal tissues, products that come from perinatal tissues, such as umbilical cord, placental tissue, Wharton's jelly. We see more and more exosome offerings, and of course, this is a new and exciting technology, but it's mostly in preclinical stages. At the same time, we've seen businesses offering exosome treatments, claiming that they're safe and effective. So that's another area, emerging area. And we also see some rise in speculative cell banking services. Some of these cell banks have been around for some time now, offering, for example, freezing of dental tissue. Some are new, and I'm specifically referring to the banking of T-cells for future generation of CAR T-cells. And again, that goes to my earlier point that we have a new exciting technology, cellular immunotherapies, that are, a lot of them are approved throughout in several jurisdictions. And we see cell banks emerging when they offer freezing of T-cells for future applications without a clear or regulated path to clinical translation. So I would say these are the main areas we currently see. And of course, we all have the all-time favorites, offering of adipose tissue-derived products, bone marrow extracts. So these haven't completely disappeared, but I would say that coexist now with new technologies.